You know you're onto something really good when even the experts are baffled, stumped, bewildered, whatever you want to call it. These next videos really had people buzzing, yet totally confused, and you're about to see why. From explosive craters in Siberia to indigenous petroglyphs back in the United States, chocolate hills in the Philippines to a mysterious vortex in Oregon, these astounding clips aren't meant to confuse the masses. They just do. So be warned, science lovers. But you may have more questions than answers when we're done today. Here are 15 mysterious things that left scientists scratching their heads. Number 15. Octopus stroll. Octopuses are some pretty amazing marine animals. They live and breathe underwater, so at low tide, one would expect them to be imprisoned in rocky pools. No problem. Need to get from one place to another? On land or under the sea? Easy. These cephalopods are quite mobile in either case. Everyone knows that octopus have 8 sucker-covered arms. Man-made suction cups pale in comparison to natural ones that cover the undersides of their arms, about 240 suckers on each limb, and a particularly large sucker can hold up to 35 pounds. The suckers are also extremely sensitive. They can pick up subtle chemical signals and move individually, even folding in half in a pinching gesture. But recently, hordes of octopus have left seagoers speechless with an unusual invasion in Wales. More than 25 of the creatures were spotted making their way up the beach. While octopuses have been spotted playing with dolphins off the coast, this is the first time video footage has been captured in the area. Why? It could simply be injury sustained by the rough weather itself, or there could be a sensitivity to a change in atmospheric pressure. Either way, this is highly unusual behavior. But when they need to, an octopus has no trouble taking a stroll. Now, let's get ready for today's open discussion. One look at this image and you're probably thinking, oh heck no. What exactly is this thing trapped in a dark shaft with a ladder? One thing's for sure, nobody in their right mind would stick around to find out. But if our sharpened monster senses could guess, this looks like a chupacabra. Literally goat sucker in Spanish. This beast is a legendary creature in the folklore of parts of the Americas and is said to attack and drink the blood of livestock. Physical descriptions of the creature vary, with some describing it as more of a dog-like creature, while most others say it's a reptilian and alien-like one. Whatever it looks like to you, apparently sightings have been reported since the 1970s, as far north as Maine, as far south as Chile, and even outside the Americas in countries like Russia and the Philippines. What do you think? What would you do in this situation? Share your ideas with the world using the hashtag #OpenDiscussion. You want to know a little secret? If you smash the like button, subscribe, and click the notification bell, you'll have superpowers for the rest of your life. So what are you waiting for? Time to fly. Number 14, a river on fire. From a boat recently, a politician in Australia reached down and struck a lighter over the escaping methane gas on the Condamine River, causing a huge burst of flames to shoot up into his face and the river to catch on fire. Who does that? He captured the amazing footage that figuratively caught fire on his social media. Speaking to press, the politician said it was implausible that the gas flow was not linked to the coal seam gas industry and fracking. In case you didn't know, fracking is the process of injecting liquid and high pressure into subterranean rocks, boreholes, etc., so as to force open existing fissures and extract oil or gas. But this river of fire might not be at the hands of industry. Local researchers insisted it was unlikely that the gas seep was linked to fracking in the region. There were naturally occurring fissures in the rock in that part that were owing to the coal beds being less than 60 feet from the surface. Methane had been known to leak out. The presence of the industry there has not caused that crack to occur or that fault to occur. It's been there for eons. The gas has probably been coming to the surface there for as long as people have been there. Number 13. Mystery mushroom. This species has only been collected in 3 places so far: Texas, Oklahoma, and Japan. And despite scientists' best efforts to unravel the mystery behind its strange distribution, the answer remains unclear. What's the deal with this mushroom? This rare fungus goes by the nickname Devil's Cigar, and with good reason. It resembles a small cigar in its early stages, lives on certain types of dead trees, and releases a spore cloud and has a hiss when fully grown. There's a legend among old Texan mushroom hunters that if you hear the legendary but extremely rare hiss of a devil cigar, you'll forever have good luck for the rest of your life. The fruit body looks like a fuzzy brown cigar at first. Upon reaching maturity, it starts peeling itself back as if it were a blossoming flower of death and releases the aforementioned spores and sound. The final product is a dull-colored, inedible, star-shaped mushroom that may be reliant on decaying organic matter for nutrition. While the fungus is hissing and releasing its spores, it also lets out a cloud of smoke, which is also a rare occurrence in fungi. Hence the name, Devil's Cigar. Number 12. Cloud falls from sky. Conspiracy theorists and sky watchers were left debating the cause of bizarre foam clouds that have been filmed falling from the sky in Morocco. The video showing a strange white substance settling across the coastal region quickly went viral, amassing a countless number of views. So far, explanations have included everything from alien intervention to government weather manipulation and naturally occurring sea foam. What do you think? The clip shows a man wandering through the formations, which up close looks similar to candy floss. He grabs a handful of the stuff, which clings to his arms like a spider's web. The strange cloud-like formations cover large areas of the landscape, some being just small wisps, while others being huge. While some viewers said the cloud-like formations seen in this video are weather manipulation or the result of chemtrails, a long-running conspiracy claim, there is said it could be alien intervention or simply naturally occurring sea foam carried by the winds. Meteorologists, however, suggested the material is just artificial foam, as the clouds in the video are unable to settle. And unlike sea foam, the artificial foam is pure white. Number 11. Alien petroglyphs. On a rock shelter wall at the bend in this canyon creek is one of the largest panels of the Barrier Canyon-style petroglyphs in the world. Horseshoe Canyon has one of the finest and most well-known rock art sites ever. Painted on the rock shelter wall are about 20 life-sized human-like images, the largest being over 6 feet tall. On the far left of the Great Gallery are a handful of striking figures. As they seem to hover on the rock face, these figures are said to have a ghostly appearance and are sometimes called the Holy Ghosts. Besides the strikingly impressive panel, there are a few other smaller rock shelters with rock art in the canyon. It's a relatively small parcel of land just west of the northern tip of Canyonlands National Park. The indigenous people who once used this canyon as a seasonal home left behind images of human-like figures, animals, and other objects on the sandstone walls, creating what archaeologists considered the largest display of Barrier Canyon-style petroglyphs painted on stone and petroglyphs. The people settling and traveling through Horseshoe Canyon left few clues behind, but artifacts found in the canyon date back as early as 9000 BC. Number 10. Chocolate Hills. These distinctive round hills in the Philippines, usually covered in green grass, dry up and turn brown in color during the dry season. Some as tall as 400 feet, there are more than 1,000 of them spread over an area of almost 20 square miles. According to legends, the hills came to be because two feuding giants hurled rocks, boulders, and sand at each other. Another legend claims what really happened was a heartbroken giant cried out a lot of tears, which led to the formation of these limestone hills. Either way, Chocolate Hills were declared a National Geological Monument in 1988, and rightfully so. The formation of the Chocolate Hills is still a mystery. Even geologists have not been able to reach a consensus in regards to the formation of this natural phenomenon. A commonly accepted geological theory is that the earth lumps were formed as a result of marine limestone, lying on a clay base that's impenetrable, weathering for thousands of years. And while the hills do vary in size, looking at these from afar, it seems like they're almost symmetrical in shape. This results in a majestic landscape that might make you think it's man-made. Often dubbed as the eighth wonder of the world, the Philippines' chocolate hills look like a field of giant Hershey Kisses. Number 9. Overton Bridge. Located near the village of Milton in Scotland is a bridge that, for some reason or another, has caused dogs to leap to their deaths since the early 60s. Not only have the dogs been plummeting to their deaths from the bridge, but many have witnessed the animals actually climbing the wall before making the jump. Some believe it to be a gravitational anomaly. Others think that there's a strange scent that attracts dogs. Some of them believe that there are paranormal factors at work, driving the dogs to jump to their deaths. One theory is that a grieving widow, the White Lady of Overton, maintains a ghostly presence at the bridge, stirring the dogs into a death frenzy. In truth, it's almost certain that these dogs are not committing suicide, but rather something is luring them off the bridge before the dogs have time to realize the height. Even stranger are the reports of dogs surviving their brush with death, only to return to the bridge for a second attempt. Animal behaviorists visited the bridge and concluded that dogs certainly weren't killing themselves on purpose, but they figured that most of the dogs that jump are long-nosed types with especially keen odor-tracking skills. Wild animal scents may be a trigger, and the dogs take matters into their own paws. Number 8. Monolith. Then came the monoliths. In 2020, authorities were conducting a routine flyover in the southeastern part of Utah, trying to count the region's bighorn sheep, when they came across this, the original mystery monolith. The isolated silver slab became a sensation, prompting speculation that extraterrestrials were involved, as with the monoliths made famous in Stanley Kubrick's 2001 A Space Odyssey, a movie from 1968. Others figured it might be an art installation or guerrilla marketing for some yet unknown media property. And then the Utah monolith suddenly disappeared, on the same day that a new one in Romania popped up, only to vanish itself less than a week later. It baffled locals and the world went wild after it hit the web. And then a roundabout in the Democratic Republic of Congo has become the latest site occupied by the mystery metallic monolith after similar objects elsewhere caught the fancy of science fiction fans. There have been as many as 200 reports of them to date. Most copycats have materialized in outdoor locations, but one did pop up in a South African grocery store. All in all, there have been sightings as far afield as Italy, Colombia, New Zealand, India, Bolivia, Japan, and Norway, among other countries. Number 7. Tomato genes. Who knew that tomatoes were such a big deal? Plant geneticists from 14 different countries spent the last 9 years mapping the genetic makeup of the tomato. They have discovered that the tomato contains 7,000 more genes than a human being. The tomato genome has been decoded. The tomato, thought to be a fruit by botanists, has been officially decreed a vegetable by the U.S. Supreme Court. The verdict is not that unreasonable given that the tomato has a close cousin to another vegetable, namely the potato. The genomes of the two plants have 92% of their DNA in common, the tomato researchers discovered. But don't worry, that the tomato and potato contain so many genes does not mean that they're more sophisticated than people. But why map the tomato genomes at all? Scientists hope to use the information to breed better tomatoes. And the tomato genome is both of intrinsic interest and a key to understanding the very versatile family of plants to which it belongs, which includes the potato, the tobacco plant, the pepper, the eggplant, and deadly nightshade. Number 6. Why cats purr? Attention, cat lovers. Our feline friends begin purring when they're a few days old, which helps their mothers locate them for feeding time. This may persist with some adult cats who purr as they feed, or who purr beforehand as they try and convince a human it's dinner time. And we love it each and every time. It's arguably the most recognizable sign of animal contentment. An adorable rasp that erupts whenever a cat is stroked. It sounds like happiness, right? But that's not quite the full story. There's a lot more going on with the cat's purr than you might expect. Even the how was long a subject of debate. Some thought purring was linked to blood flowing to a vein that carries blood to the right side of the heart. But with more research, it seemed likelier that the noise comes from the muscles within the cat's larynx. As they move, they dilate and constrict the part of their larynx that surrounds the vocal cords, and the air vibrates every time the cat breathes in or out. The result is the purr. Some will purr loudly when they're cautiously investigating new environments. Cats may also purr after they've been startled or after stressful episodes like being chased by a dog. Even though science is now fairly sure this is the process, there's no definitive answer as to what triggers the response. Number 5. Yawning is contagious. Scientific investigators may not agree on the functions of yawning or why it's contagious, but they do confirm that humans can catch a yawn from observing other people yawn. Researchers conducted various studies to determine if and when yawning is contagious. One experiment divided 360 college students into 12 groups. Some students watched video clips of yawning faces, while others observed featureless or smiling faces. Significantly more students yawned after being exposed to the yawning faces than did those watching faces exhibiting other expressions. And we're not surprised. They also found that observing, hearing, reading about, or thinking about yawns stimulates people to yawn. From an evolutionary standpoint, the absence of contagious yawning in other species suggests that human primates yawned as a way to coordinate social behavior, such as signaling an event that requires alertness or preparing for sleep. Granted, yawning is not a problem for most people, so limited research has been done on the topic. Have you ever been in a class or a meeting and someone starts yawning? Pretty soon you may find yourself starting a yawn as well. See? Yawning is contagious. Number 4. Siberia Mystery Craters. This appeared in Siberia recently, suddenly and explosively, leaving a ragged pockmark on the barren landscape. And there are many more of them. The latest crater was spotted by a TV crew as they flew past with a team of scientists during an expedition with local authorities. Around the crater's edge, the earth is a torn, gray jumble of ice and clods of permafrost. The roots of plants, newly exposed around the rim, show signs of scorching. It gives some idea of just how violently this hole in the middle of the Siberian Arctic materialized. From the air, the freshly exposed dirt stands out against the green tundra and dark lakes around it. The layers of earth and rock exposed further inside the cylindrical hole are almost black, and a pool of water is already forming at the bottom by the time scientists reach it. This was the 17th crater of its kind to be found in the Russian Arctic since 2013. And predictably, there was a load of bizarre theories about the origins of the holes. Thankfully, scientists have used science to get us some scientific answers. A methane gas buildup in an ice cavity caused a mound to form at ground level, which eventually exploded, leaving behind a crater. Why exactly the methane is building up is yet to be conclusively proven, but it seems likely climate change could be a part of it. Number 3. Voynich Manuscript. This document has puzzled cryptographers for a century. It's handwritten in a writing system that's yet to be deciphered, but experts think this unusual document was written in the 15th century. So, what does the Voynich manuscript say? Would you believe it? No one knows. In fact, experts aren't even sure what language it's in. A recent study found that the writing is likely Hebrew, but it may also be in Malay, Arabic, or Amharic. Plus, it's full of strange illustrations. It has images of people, castles, and dragons. There are also drawings of strange plants and astronomical signs. To make decoding matters worse, the Voynich manuscript was likely written in code. Most experts think a substitution cipher was used. In this method, a person could encode a message by switching some letters of the alphabet with made-up characters. That means we may never know what was truly written by the author. Still, whoever wrote it had a lot to say. Today, the book contains 246 pages. Those who have studied the document say that some pieces may be missing. Would you like to try your hand at reading the Voynich manuscript? Maybe you'll make the next breakthrough that cracks the code. Number 2. Golden Pagoda Balancing Rock. Resting atop Mount Kiatkio is one of the most sacred religious sites in the world in Myanmar and Burma. And apparently, gravity doesn't even work here. The Kiatkio Pagoda, aka the Golden Rock of Myanmar, stands 24 feet tall in total. And as you can see, it's massive and unbelievably heavy. The boulder rests on the edge of a cliff with more than half of its surface leaning out over open air. It's hard to fathom how that's even possible. But there it is. Wait until you hear the origin story. The boulder has become sacred among spiritual enthusiasts because, legend has it, the boulder remains in place because it's perfectly balanced on a strand of Buddha's hair. On one of the many visits, Buddha gave a strand of his hair to a hermit. The hermit gave the hair to the king, asking that it be enshrined in a boulder. With a little mystical help, the king found a place for the hair on the top of Mount Kiatkio, and there the hair and the boulder remained. Around the pagoda are an atmosphere of devotion with the burning candles, the chanting of devotees, the smell of incense sticks, and the offerings being made to the shrine. It's said that this place has been a Buddhist place of worship for 2,600 years. Number 1. Oregon Vortex. Welcome to one of Oregon's best-known roadside attractions, found between Grants Pass and Medford in southern Oregon. The Vortex first opened in 1930 and has been drawing tourists ever since. An office was built in the area in 1904, which slid from its foundation, coming to rest at an odd angle. In 1914, the outpost was rediscovered by a prospector named William McClough, who convinced a geologist and engineer to research the paranormal phenomena of the so-called 165-foot magnet radius. Many of those experiments are what tour guides at the Vortex still show today. Apparent changes in height, objects appearing to roll uphill, and an unseen force that in some places seems to pull you off balance. Yet they have no explanation for the phenomenon. Visitors tend to offer their own, from biblical rapture to quantum leap. But the guides don't play favorites, armed instead with levels and boards. They're just to show off the mystery. The closest thing the owners have to an explanation is this. Present on this land is a whirlpool of force that plays with your perspective. As you walk toward magnetic south, you appear to grow taller. As you go back toward magnetic north, you appear to get shorter. And figuring it out isn't really the point. It's more fun to just experience the strange attraction, smile, and let the mystery of the Vortex sink in. Hopefully you're not left scratching your head after these videos, but they are proof that even scientists get stumped by a mystery every now and again. Like and subscribe, and share as well.